Morning students, up till now we have studied about different parts of alimentary canal and salivary glands, liver and pancreas. Now we will be studying about the different steps of nutrition. The steps of nutrition include ingestion, digestion, which occurs in buccal cavity, stomach and intestine. After digestion, the digested food is absorbed in the intestine. Then the next step is assimilation and ejection. We will study these steps one by one. The first step of nutrition is ingestion. Ingestion occurs in two steps. Ingestion actually means intake of food. After the intake of food, the food is chewed up with the help of teeth. It is masticated and broken down into simpler pieces. And then this semi-solid food is known as bolus. And then it is swallowed. When the food is ingested, that is, it is broken down into smaller pieces, then it triggers the reflex, because of which the salivary gland releases saliva along with mucin, which help to moisten the food, and saliva perform different functions. Digestion. Digestion occurs in different part of alimentary canal, that is in buccal cavity, in stomach, in small intestine. In digestion, bigger food molecules are broken down into smaller molecules. Digestion begins in buccal cavity. In buccal cavity, as we have studied, that salivary gland are present. Salivary gland secrete saliva, which have the pH of 6.8. This saliva is mixed with food. This saliva contains an enzyme, salivary amylase. This salivary amylase acts on the starch molecule. Since the food remains in buccal cavity for a short period of time, so the starch is partially digested. When salivary amylase act on starch, it breaks down the particle into maltose and alpha limit dextrin. The bicarbonate ion, which are present in the saliva, neutralize the acidity, your acid which is present in the food. Now from buccal cavity, the food is passed to stomach through esophagus, and further digestion occur in stomach. After the food is digested in buccal cavity through esophagus, now it reaches to stomach. In the stomach, the food remains for 4 to 5 hours. It is known as chyme. As we have studied in the structure of stomach, that different type of glands secrete gastric juice. These gastric juice are acted on the food which comes from the esophagus. This gastric juice contains HCl, prorenin, mucus, pepsinogen and gastric lipase. HCl makes the food highly acidic. It reduces the pH of stomach, and because of this reduced pH, activity of lipase becomes very very slow. But this HCl is important for converting the inactive pepsinogen to pepsin and inactive prorenin to renin. Thus HCl plays an important role in forming the active pepsin, which act on protein and converts it to simpler molecules called protease, peptones and polypeptides. This HCl also activates prorenin to renin, which is important for coagulation of milk. The reduced pH makes the activity of lipase very slow, and because of this, fat are digested incompletely. Milk fat, however, to small amount is digested to fatty acid and glycerol. In the stomach, specially tributyrin, the fat which is present in the butter is semi-digested. Now, after the digestion of protein, the food becomes thick, acidic and semi-digested and is known as chyme. This HCl can damage the wall of the stomach, so to protect this wall from the action of enzymes, the layer of mucus produced by goblet cell makes a coating on the outer wall of stomach and protect it from the action of HCl. Thus, the digestion of protein is the main step in stomach. After this, the food passes to intestine.